Hello, folks, and welcome back to City Skylines. As always, of course, I'm Falcon, your host. And last time we expanded and built out this little section of the city here, a new, primarily residential with some commercial in it. If you look at the districting, those commercial on the edges. Basically, very similar to how I did over here. You know, aside from down here, it's basically, and over here, I suppose, it's pretty much all residential core with commercial on the outsides. It seems to work pretty well most of the time. Now, we have a traffic nightmare down here on this on-ramp, because it's presently about the only way to get into the city. And not only is it the only way to get into the city itself, it's also the only way for them to... Well, okay, not the only way, but it's the best way, really, for them to go from the main area up here, residential region to the industrial region. And the industrial region is where most of our people are working. So it's really proving to be obnoxious. We're gonna have to do something about that. I'm not entirely prepared to do anything about it right this second, though. I think our priority right now needs to be getting a hospital built. And a fire department, and a police headquarters. And I mean the actual fire station, not just the house. We really kind of need these upgraded things to really be able to accomplish what we're trying to do here. Because it's just, it's too, too expensive. Building the lesser things. In the grand scheme of things, because these ones are much better than the lesser ones. I mean, see, this would be the equivalent of 5 of these things. And sure, that's less money, both in upkeep and actual cost, but you have to have 5 of them scattered around. You have to have 5 individual things, and that takes space. And space is one thing that we are somewhat limited in. Not significantly, but limited, nevertheless. Say I could build there, do something to get them power, but yeah, it just got connected. I wasn't too worried. I figured that was going to connect itself fairly quickly. I wasn't that concerned. Now, we are getting very low on electricity, and we also are going to need another recycling place fairly soon. I might even gonna need more water and sewage as well, but we're doing okay for the time being. We don't necessarily have to jump into that just yet. We will soon enough, but not just yet. Now, one thing you may note fairly immediately is the color of the pollution has been changed, at least on the land. Not water, I kept water the same, though I consider changing that too, but the land was changed. It's no longer that nasty, disgusting looking purple. Now, that nasty, disgusting-looking purple, the only good thing about it was very obvious. This brown that it does now is much more realistic. But while it is more realistic, it's also slightly harder to see. It's not as clearly noticeable. That's okay. I do also have... Is it? Yeah, this. I do also have marquee demoing available. We can demolish all these trees. Demolish trees for days. This is good because the simulation, the game, can only handle so many trees at once on an entire map. And, oh, we can delete trees that aren't even on our, or we can control. That's interesting. It also lets you demolish buildings and nodes, which would be things like roads and stuff. Actually, nodes, the fact that I can demolish stuff outside this also lets me demolish that. Because I can demolish things outside of my territory now, so I can actually delete, like I could delete the roads and stuff if I wanted to. That would be very bad, actually. That's a terrible, terrible idea. Don't do that. But you could delete outside the world, outside what you're ever able to buy. Which would actually screw you, because then you would lose your outside connection. Don't do it. But you can, if you so choose. Let's turn that off. No. Go away. Go away. Go away. There we go. Screw you. Oh god, still doing it. Oh, maybe it's not still doing it. Whatever. Switch to something else. Switch to the building. There we go. I'll get rid of it. Ooh, we got lots of money now. Okay. First things first. I figure... Let's see. Fire is really important. We have some serious fire danger. In a good chunk of the city, really. That would solve much of it. Though maybe not perhaps all of it. See, where you place them, as far as, like, what you place them off of, road-wise, it has a huge impact on where they can get. This is probably a really good idea to put it here, because this will serve this entire, the entire industrial region. But, it won't really solve my problems up here. At least not really well. I mean, I might get a little bit of coverage up there, but it's not going to do most of the coverage that I really need. Police is, I'm less, far less concerned about police. We really don't need police as much as we do hospital. Really need to get built. Ooh, hospitals are big. Really big. Oh god, bug just flew in my eye. Screw you, bug. That's pretty good, because that covers up into the residential area up there. Pretty effectively. Doesn't really cover down in all of the industrial stuff like I would like. That said, it's still probably the better place to build it. Now this is commercial. Okay, so let's build the hospital, because we need the hospital, I think, more than we need the other stuff. So there's the hospital. That'll solve, as you can see, that solves most of our medical problems. Still got a little bit of lack of coverage down here, but I can pretty easily fill that in really quick with a basic clinic right there, and that covers the spot that we're missing, basically. And then we do have some empty spot up here, so once we have enough money, if I build another one here, that should cover it. Damn, that's loud. If I build another one, like, right here, that should cover that. And that'll give us all the coverage we need as far as that goes. That's gonna be the main focus of this episode, is getting coverage for fire, police, and healthcare. Because we do kind of need these things. Okay. Build another one of you there. So we got one of these on either end, one kind of smack dab in the middle, and then the big hospital there. I think that covers the medical for now. We shouldn't need any more than that, really, probably ever. Now, I think I'm going to do basically the same thing with the firehouse. I'm going to build the firehouse right here. That should cover a good chunk of all this, and then we might have to build the fire station, that is, and then we might have to build a firehouse down here and one up there as well, just to get everything, you know, completely covered how we want it, how we need it, in fact. But shouldn't be too awful bad. So, budget-wise, we're doing good. Where is most of our expenses going? Roads, electricity, trash, ugh. Medical went up quite a bit, but not doing that bad, I suppose. Getting about half of the income, half of the expenditure for buses we're getting back. So we're not doing too bad there. Okay, so medical and garbage are where most of our shit is going. Not good. Alright, electricity is in a danger zone. Danger, Will Robinson, danger. But I think we're still okay for a moment. I'm almost certain we're gonna have to do this anyway, so let's just go ahead and build one down here. Build one of those there. Build one of these up here. Oh, we don't have enough money. Crap. Speed forward, my good sir. See, our income is increasing. Well, sort of increasing. Yes, it is increasing, but not that quickly. Build one of those there. That gives us coverage for a good chunk of stuff, and then if we build the fire station here, next to the hospital, that'll give us coverage everywhere else. That'll handle that. Police, again, I'm less concerned about. We do need another one. We probably don't need a police headquarters right away, though I might build one anyway. That's less, far less important at the moment. Let's see, elementary school. Might actually need another elementary school. High school was still plenty good. Don't have to worry about that. Might actually need to build another elementary school though, because we might need some coverage, additional coverage over here. But we're not doing too bad there. I don't like how, because of the hill, I don't like how this is looking. It looks terrible. Now, there's actually still plenty of communities in real life that actually kind of look like this, though, so... I've seen communities that have, like, this terraced crap going on, like what we have here. It's disgusting looking, but it actually does happen in real life, so... It's not that bad, but it just looks so bad. So bad. Compared to the rest of the place. Oh, we can also... Because we were able to delete that. Is that what I did? Did I do... What is this? What lane? What? How many lanes are you? 3 lane apiece. 1, 2... Is this 2 now? Not up here. Yeah, okay, that's what this is. Okay. That's fine. So, let's build from there to... Come on. Come on. Why you know? Why you do this to me? Come on. Come on. Damn you, game. There we go. Less than ideal, but whatever. Take it, I guess. It does bother me that we have this space here, but there's not really a whole hell of a lot I can do about it right now, so... Not too terribly concerned. Okay. That's good. That gets part of what I wanted done up there finished. Even though it looks a little nasty, it does accomplish the main thing that we were trying to do. Okay. So, the other big project that we have to do, either this episode or next episode, although we have plenty of time in this episode, so we'll probably do this one, is I need to do something, I need to create another in route for traffic. Now, it's going to be pretty expensive, so I'm going to wait, I think, until we have the, until we can put down the fire station, because it's going to take a lot of money. Ooh, we can get trains. Nice. It's with 9,000. Okay. We're almost there. Although our growth is pretty lethargic at the time, for the moment. Which is fine, actually. I'm totally okay with that. The other thing I do want to build is some metro stations. And we are going to build that. Let's see, what is this bus line doing here? Eh, you're doing pretty good work, actually. 43%. I was worried that maybe it wasn't going to work as well as I would like. Don't have that many passengers, though, but also not a super populated area of the city yet. So I suppose that's not necessarily that important. It's not looking too bad. I do want to build some metro stations, but they are really expensive. But I would like to get a metro running. We don't necessarily need it yet, but it would help alleviate some of the traffic problems. So, there's that. Now, where are you guys just coming from off? Yeah, I think you're coming from off the map. So it probably will behoove us to... Okay, so we're plenty fine on cemeteries. We need to get to 1,400, so we got almost twice our present population before we can build crematories. Which is what we really need to do. Get this done. I don't know if destination, I don't know if this is a crematory place or if it is a cemetery. Sure. I really don't know. I think it's a crematory. I'm not certain. It has to be a crematory, though, because it can't be a cemetery, because it doesn't have the capacity to be a cemetery, not for that price. No point. There'd be no point in building it. So... Oh, yeah, the other thing that we have, coming to roads here, you'll see, there's new types of roads. I have downloaded and put in Traffic +++. I was somewhat reluctant to do that. And if I can figure out exactly how to use Traffic +++, I will perhaps help you see why I was reluctant to do that. Busways and the really big roads. It's like you do. It's not good, actually. Alright, now can we still remove... Can. Good. I might do this then. Still a little reluctant to fiddle with it because I don't know exactly how effective buses will be. Although, to be honest, they're only using one fucking lane of traffic anyway, so I guess it doesn't really make that much difference now, does it? Okay, let's do it. I don't know how much I really want to use this, but by the looks of things, I'm not bloody using the right stuff anyway, so why the hell not, I guess. Can this be upgraded without demolishing buildings? And that would be awesome. Okay, awesome. Very good. Let's do it then. That, of course, would demolish buildings, but if we can upgrade these big main roads, though, and upgrade the big thoroughfares here with the bus lanes, that'll help. That'll help the traffic in and of itself, because it'll take the buses out of the, it'll take the buses out of the more minor... out of the way of the other traffic. So it'll help a lot with some congestion. Because we have a lot of buses, and removing the buses from the path is even costing us money. It's not. At least not here, anyway. Anyway, if we can remove the buses from the path of most of the other traffic, that in of itself will help it's not going to help as much as we need it to. We need to do more than just this. But it will help with some of the traffic problems. Certainly won't help with all of it, unfortunately, but there's actually not a whole hell of a lot we can do that will help with all of it, so that really doesn't mean anything. Not helping with all of it doesn't really do mean anything to us, because it's not going to help with all of it anyway. To move them. Okay. Obviously that doesn't help everywhere. It doesn't help on some of the lesser roads, but it does help on these roads. And helping on these roads is probably useful anyway. Now, unfortunately, that has messed up every damn traffic light in the freaking whole entire city. Definitely here. Really messed up the traffic lights here. And everywhere else, pretty much. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to go through and fix every single traffic light in the city now. Go through and disable them all. Once again. So that we don't have traffic nightmare from the lights. Because there's not much point in doing things to try to remove some of the traffic if the if we just immediately shoot ourselves in the foot by adding a million lights everywhere. Like that right there, that would have been a nightmare. Three traffic lights, like 2 feet from each other? No. Really, really unhelpful. Remarkably unhelpful, in fact. So remarkably unhelpful that there's really no point in even bothering to mess with it. Oops. Why is that even a thing? That doesn't even make sense to me. Why is that even a spot that you could possibly have a light? No point. No point whatsoever for that being there. That doesn't make sense. Whatever. Anyway, that should help with some of the traffic. And I don't know how to work the rest of traffic plus plus, actually. I don't know how. Why is there? I don't know how to fiddle with that. I don't know how that works. No. I don't know what that was for a second. I don't know how. Precisely how that operates. I know that should clear up some of the traffic though, because the buses will now be able to get past without slowing down, and the other traffic will be forced into other lanes, which is perfectly fine because basically what it does is it forces them to use more than one lane. If only for, you know, some small portion of the traffic. But you see the buses, like, this is all backed up here, but the buses just keep going. Like, they just keep driving. They hit their stops and they just keep going. They don't have to stop which will speed up the bus traffic. May even force people, or encourage people, not force, but encourage them to use buses more, and just remove some vehicles from the traffic lanes, which is helpful in and of itself. The main thing that we really need to do, though, is we need to be able to, move you up to there. Need to move you over to there. So that we can continue the bus lane roads. Down to there. There we go. Not very important right this second, but it will be because we're going to extend this passage here. It's not going to end there. This pass is going to continue out here down into this region. And this region is going to have another exit ramp off of the highway. I will, off camera, either maybe this episode or maybe next episode, maybe go into traffic. What's traffic? No, that doesn't seem to do it. Yeah, but see, this is a freaking nightmare. Not working. This is not working. Is there a... I wouldn't really do anything, though. Public service vehicles. Public service vehicles, but are primarily for pedestrians. They like the paths, but service vehicles can get on them too. It's cool. Not necessarily super, super useful, but cool, nevertheless. Oh, probably fix a couple lights. Yep. Okay, yeah, well, that's helped some. Although, nowhere near enough. The main thing that we need to do is we need to get rid of these, all this industrial traffic. We need to route it somewhere else. And that's what I'm going to do next, is we're going to force it all to come down this lane, coming down this direction, and get onto the highway this way. That's going to be our next thing, but I do want to get, what was it, the fire department. We want to get the fire station built. So I'm going to fast forward until we have enough money for that. That has to be my next priority, is getting that constructed, because we really need that built. We need that built before we need most of this other stuff. Because right now, Lord knows, we don't got enough. Okay. That looks pretty good. That looks a pretty good placement. That provides major fire support for a good chunk of the city, in and of itself. That's the other thing, is the service vehicles are also benefiting from the bus lanes, because I believe they can also take the bus lanes. Well, it's not just buses, it will also help the get the service vehicles out of the road, in addition to the buses, of course. Which is useful. So, let's see. Now. My priority needs to be to get more electricity, because we need more electricity. I'm gonna build another one of these, for the time being. These are temporary stopgaps. What I really want to build, is one of these. This thing is... It's broken. It's a cheap thing, really. But it does 200 megawatts output, for only 200 upkeep a week, which is just ridiculous. Like, this is the closest thing, probably. The solar plant has almost as much output, but look, it's like 6 times the upkeep. Although the initial cost is less, but like, you know, there we go. At the oil plant, way less cost, but way more upkeep for less output. You know, I mean, it is significantly different, significant differences in output. The only thing that even comes vaguely close, that's not too bad actually, because that's considerable amount of output there for still a lot of money, but it looks cool too. Is this okay? So that's just an straight upgrade of the regular power plant, because it's the same upkeep, same cost, but more production. And then of course you have nuclear, which is massive output, but also massive cost. Yeah, this is probably the most efficient overall, but you have to have a lot of money to do it, and we are not anywhere even vaguely close to having that kind of money to throw around right now. We're a long ways from having that kind of money to throw around, unfortunately. The other thing we will have to do something with, like I said, it's a far less of a concern right now, but we do definitely need... I'll probably build another, like I said, I'll probably build a police headquarters, but for the time being, we can roll with it without it. But I do need to build a police headquarters to service, like, all this region that doesn't have such things, because they are very much short of that kind of stuff. You need here. You just need more education. Okay. Alright, now we can build high capacity stuff now, and this is going, we're going to build a high capacity area over here. But I need to do something with this traffic first. That unfortunately has to be the priority. What does this build? Does this build... build a 3-lane, 1-way road. Okay. Okay, this is what I might do. We'll cross this over the road here. Just go straight across the water there. We don't need to do anything fancy. Water's not ever gonna get high enough to threaten this bridge, and there's no reason to like raise it up or whatever, because that just takes more room and space and wastes time, basically. Alright, so let's do that. That gets us expanding down into here. I did buy this other chunk down here. I'm not going to use it anytime soon, but, you know, when and if we choose to use it. Well, we will eventually, but that'll be probably a long time from now. I'm going to expand into this area next, and this is going to be high residential, probably in this chunk, and then high commercial, like over here. I think is how I'm going to run that. Or maybe vice versa. I don't know. That'll be next episode, though. Let's get this built real quick, and then I'm going to end the episode here. Okay, so what we need to do... I'm going to come off of this ramp here. We're actually going to go down until we're underground. Oh, that took some money. Holy crap, that took some money. Holy crap, that took some money. Wow. Okay. Oh, we might actually hit the 9,000 mark without having to do anything, but it's gonna take a while. Okay, so this will be the off-ramp, obviously. Let's actually use the freeform here. We use curved. Ooh, that's expensive. Trying to decide if maybe I should use See, what I really want is a two-lane, one-way road. But I want a two-lane, one-way but I want one lane to be buses and the other lane to be regular traffic. Because right now we don't have anything like that. Yeah, there's just no option for anything like that right now. Sucks. Oh well. Oh well, I guess. Okay, so we need to just continue to make money here because we need a lot more money than we've got. I had no idea that underground stuff here was so expensive. Or I may not have tried to do it, use it. Oh well. Alright, so let's come to right about here. Oops. We need to come up. We come back above ground. Go. That's coming in one way. Now we need to do basically the same thing going the other direction. It's coming off the ramp, Mike. We'll have to do the same thing again going on, which is going to be obviously ridiculously expensive, but fortunately there's only so much I can do about it. Alright, so we want to be equal to here. So I want maybe 7 that way, 7 that way. Bulldoze you, and you, 7 that way, and oops. Too far that direction, 7 that way. 7, 7. That looks not look right. It is right, but it doesn't look right. Oops. we go. That gives us a good size roundabout there. Polish all that. Upgrade this to... Oh, I just realized we made a mistake over here. We made this go two ways now. Well, it's actually not necessarily a problem, because the traffic is still not going where it should be going anyway. See, we need one way. Nah, I think this needs to all be one way. I think I did make a mistake here. The roundabout needs to be one way, because it'll messes up if you don't have it one way to here. It's unfortunate, but I think it's true. So as much as I would rather it not be, you have to have one way there. Because I think that helps traffic move better if they're going the right same direction. If it's all the same direction. I think that works better that way. Okay. Anyway, where were we? I'm actually going to go ahead and end the episode here, folks. So thank you for watching. I'm going to work on this off-camera a little bit and get this road thing set up here like I wanted it to be. And if we get really close to 9,000, I'll keep an eye on it. And if I get really close to that, I will try and... I'll try and start recording before we actually hit it. So thank you for watching. This has been City Skylines. I, of course, have been Falcon, your host, and I will see you all next time. Take it easy. Have a good day. Bye-bye.